Indian Mines Ministry has announced the large discovery of lithium in Jammu and Kashmir. The rare earth mineral is essential for manufacturing electric vehicles and batteries.
Now, this news has become sensational over the last few days. However, if you look into the report that is published by the government, the fine print is a little different. Let's look into this. It says that the Geological Survey of India has for the first time established lithium inferred resources G3 of 5.9 million tons in the Rizi district of Jammu and Kashmir. Now, the point is, all the news articles have removed inferred resources and G3. What does it mean? Nobody bothers. The news is that, hey, India has discovered 5.9 million tons of lithium, so it's time to celebrate. Well, let's look into what inferred resources actually mean and what does G3 actually mean. If you look in the international standards, that is CRISCO, they very clearly mention that inferred resources mean that the level of confidence with respect to the quality and quantity of the resources found is pretty limited, and also there is no economic viability still attached to that explored resource yet. And only if it moves from inferred to the next stage, that is indicated, and finally to measured, there is clearly a potential economic viability that is attached to all the resources that are found. Now, while we're still at the first stage, that is inferred, we do not know if we will successfully move into the second stage and the third stage as well. Because if you go back into the news, in 2021, there was news around, hey, lithium reserves, 1,600 tons of lithium reserves found in Karnataka. Again, inferred resources found in Karnataka. And after 2021, there is absolutely no news and everything is silent with respect to those lithium reserves. I hope this 5.9 million tons is a gigantic number compared to 1,600 tons. So this will actually go into the positive direction. Now, what is G3? If you look at the geological standards, G3 indicates the low level of confidence with respect to both the quality and the quantity of the natural mineral resources that are found. And G2 indicates moderate level of confidence, and G1 indicates that the quantity associated with the known deposit can be estimated with high level of confidence. So the level of confidence is low, and also the economic viability is not even established yet. Then still, why is everybody going gaga over this entire lithium deposits? Because of two reasons. Number one, it's a rare earth metal. If you look into the reserves that are around the world, Chile leads the tables. Chile has roughly 9.3 million tons of lithium reserves in their country. And the second one is Australia with 6.2 million tons. And the third one, if India gets into the list, India will be number three. That's a great moment. But right now it's Argentina with 2.7 million tons. Now you can see it's really rare earth metal, and with this one single exploration, India can get into the top three countries with lithium reserves. Now the point is, okay, it is rare, but what is it so special but people really want it for? The primary use case of lithium is in lithium ion batteries. And why is it important? Because of two factors. Again, number one, it is weight efficient and also volume efficient with respect to the energy it carries. And this chart depicts it in the perfect way. For example, you look at over here, the x-axis is the specific energy density, that is energy per kg, the weight. And the y-axis is the volumetric energy, that is energy per volume. Now, the point is, if you look at where lithium ion battery stands, it is easily beating all the other kinds of rechargeable batteries that are out there in the market. And for example, if we look at our phones, we want a smartphone which is light and also something that can fit into our pocket. So we are looking at both weight efficiencies and also volume efficiencies. And that's the reason why lithium ion battery is actually a very important component right now in the electronics world. Similarly, the same set of characteristics are also going to be important in the EV space. Even the batteries that go into electric vehicles, lithium ion batteries are the key component to it. So the more reserves of lithium found, you can see that potentially India can be a self-sufficient state going forward with this lithium ion batteries. Now, we understand that, hey, it's a rare earth metal and also it is energy efficient with respect to weight and volume. Now, if you look at Indian current context of imports, we have imported $1.7 billion worth of lithium ion batteries in the last 1 year, in 2022 itself. With the discovery of these lithium reserves, we potentially do not have to basically go and empty our foreign reserves. That's a huge self-sufficient state for India. Now, the other interesting aspect in these lines is the boost to the EV industry itself. India in October 2021 itself has announced that by 2030, their objective is to have 30% of the entire car sales in 2030 to be electric vehicles, and that is only for the passenger vehicles. And for commercial vehicles, the goal is set at around 70%, and for two-wheelers and three-wheelers, the goal is set around 80%. And you can see that, hey, having these lithium reserves in-house can go a long way in reaching those objectives by 2030. However, there is a small problem over there. It is not just that, hey, we found lithium in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, that lithium is directly translated into a lithium ion battery that goes into our phone in the pocket. No, this lithium that we are finding in Jammu and Kashmir is in the form of hard rock. And this hard rocks then should be mined, and lithium should be extracted from these rocks and subsequently refined, processed, and then the lithium ion battery should be manufactured. And this entire process has a lot of environmental concerns to it. For example, to basically extract this particular lithium from the rock itself, you need 170 tons of water. For extracting 1 ton of lithium, you need 170 tons of water, and in the process, you will be emitting 15 tons of carbon dioxide. Now you can see that, hey, while we are saving on one side, the CO2 emissions that come through the vehicles by going into EV space, on the other hand, the lithium ion batteries, which are going and helping the entire creation of this EV industry, for creating these lithium ion batteries, we have to have so much of carbon emissions. So it's a catch-22 situation. Which devil do you want to choose? Either ways, we are going to have some kind of CO2 emissions. Now, unless and until we find these reserves, and unless and until this entire extraction process becomes sophisticated, there is absolutely no reason for us to throw caution to the wind and celebrate this moment. Also, there is one other important element. If we really get to this stage where the processes are sophisticated and also the reserves are actually found with economic viability, two big positives for India. Number one, we will be self-reliant on lithium. We won't need to go ahead and import lithium right now. And also, we will be developing those processes internally. Right now, 80% of the entire world's lithium production happens in China. So our reliance on China will also come down drastically because of this entire sophistication in the model. Now, there are two important lessons for you as well in this process. The first one, when you get to read a news, please do not ignore the fine prints. Well, the media doesn't care about the fine print. Well, you as a business student or as an aspiring entrepreneur, you need to look into the fine print at the root source of the information itself. And number two, whenever you are looking for the information, please always go and check out the benchmarks information that is available out there in the market. In this scenario, the benchmarks could come from international standards. The benchmarks could come from, hey, how much CO2 is basically coming out as emissions when 1 ton of lithium is being extracted. Please do not ignore these kind of benchmarks. These benchmarking exercises is a very critical component in the entire business world. So please do look out these two factors as well. I hope this video makes sense to you. Please go ahead, click on that like button, subscribe to the channel, and do let me know if you have any specific feedback for me too. Take care, guys. See you again. Bye-bye.